You know, kids, when they're sore at you, they won't laugh or anything. After we left the bears, we left the zoo and crossed over this little street in the park. And then we went through one of those little tunnels that always smells from somebody's taking a leak. It was on the way to the carousel. Old Phoebe still wouldn't talk to me or anything, but she was sort of walking next to me now. I took a hold of the belt at the back of her coat, just for the hell of it, but she wouldn't let me. She said, "Keep your hands to yourself, if you don't mind." She was still sore at me, but not as sore as she was before. Anyway, we kept getting closer and closer to the carousel, and you could start to hear that nutty music it always plays. It was playing "Oh Murray." It played that same song about 50 years ago when I was a little kid. That's one nice thing about carousels. They always play the same songs. "I thought the carousel was closed in the wintertime," old Phoebe said. It was the first time she practically said anything. She probably forgot she was supposed to be sore at me. "Maybe because it's around Christmas," I said. She didn't say anything when I said that. She probably remembered she was supposed to be sore at me. "Do you want to go for a ride on it?" I said. I knew she probably did. When she was a tiny little kid, and Aileen, DB, and I used to go to the park with her, she was mad about the carousel. You couldn't get her off the goddamn thing. "I'm too big," she said. I thought she wasn't going to answer me, but she did. "No, you're not. Go on. I'll wait for you. Go on," I said. We were right there then. There were a few kids riding on it, mostly very little kids, and a few parents were waiting around outside, sitting on the benches and all. What I did was, I went up to the window where they sell the tickets and bought old Phoebe a ticket. Then I gave it to her. She was standing right next to me. "Here," I said. "Wait a second. Take the rest of your dough, too." I started giving her the rest of the dough she'd lent me. "You keep it. Keep it from me," she said. Then she said right afterward, "Please." That's depressing. When somebody says please to you, I mean, if it's Phoebe or somebody, that depressed the hell out of me. But I put the dough back in my pocket. "Aren't you gonna ride too?" she asked. She was looking at me sort of funny. You could tell she wasn't too sore at me anymore. "Maybe I will the next time." "I'll watch you," I said. "Got your ticket?" "Yes." "Go ahead then. I'll be on this bench right over here. I'll watch you." I went over and sat down on this bench, and she went and got on the carousel. She walked around it. I mean, she walked once all the way around it. Then she sat down on this big, brown, beat-up looking old horse. Then the carousel started, and I watched her go around and around. There were only about 5 or 6 other kids on the rides, and the song the carousel was playing was "Smoke Gets in Your Eyes." It was playing it, very jazzy and funny. All the kids kept trying to grab for the gold ring, and so was old Phoebe, and I was sort of afraid she'd fall off the goddamn horse. But I didn't say anything or do anything. The thing with kids is, if they want to grab the gold ring, you have to let them do it and not say anything. If they fall off, they fall off, but it's bad if you say anything to them. When the ride was over, she got off her horse and came over to me. "You ride once too. This time," she said. "No, I'll just watch you." "I think I'll just watch," I said. I gave her some more of her dough. "Here, get some more tickets." She shook the dough off me. "I'm not mad at you anymore," she said. "I know. Hurry up, the thing's gonna start again." Then all of a sudden she gave me a kiss. Then she held her hand out and said, "It's raining. It's starting to rain." "I know." Then what she did, it damn near killed me. She reached in my coat pocket and took out my red hunting hat and put it on my head. "Don't you want it?" I said. "You can wear it a while." "Okay, hurry up though now. You're gonna miss your ride. You won't get your own horse or anything." She kept hanging around though. "Did you mean it, what you said? You really aren't going away anywhere? Are you really going home afterwards?" she asked me. "Yeah," I said. "I meant it too. I wasn't lying to her. I really did go home afterwards." "Hurry up now," I said. The thing's starting. She ran and bought her ticket and got back on the goddamn carousel just in time. Then she walked all the way around it till she got her own horse back. Then she got on it. She waved to me and I waved back. Boy, it began to rain like a bastard. In buckets, I swear to God. All the parents and mothers and everybody went over and stood right under the roof of the carousel, so they wouldn't get soaked to the skin or anything. But I stuck around on the bench for quite a while. I got pretty soaking wet, especially my neck and pants. My hunting hat really gave me quite a lot of protection, in a way, but I got soaked anyway. I didn't care, though. I felt so damn happy all of a sudden. The way old Phoebe kept going around and around, I was damn near bawling. I felt so damn happy. If you want to know the truth, I don't know why. It was just that she looked so damn nice, the way she kept going around and around, in her blue coat and all. God, I wish you could have been there. That's all I'm going to tell. I could probably tell you what.